We are thrilled this evening to honor 12 phenomenal women, all Girl Scout alumni, who make up our special 100th anniversary Celebrate Leadership calendars, which you will find at your place seating on your table. We will recognize a different honoree for each of the 12 months of 2012. Our Girl Scout mission is building girls of courage, confidence, and character who make the world a better place. While all of our honorees exhibit all three of these characteristics, we have divided them tonight into three groups: women of courage, women of character, women of confidence, and women of character. It is my great privilege and honor to tell you about this evening's first honoree, Anusha Askuian, who clearly demonstrates the power of courage in overcoming challenges and achieving greatness. Growing up in Iran under the late Shah's reign, Anusha experienced the challenges of life without the freedom of speech. She learned about scouting as a young girl when she spotted several older girls wearing the uniforms of Girl Guides, the international sister organization to Girl Scouts. It was a Girl Scouts brochure, however, that 10-year-old Anusha found that provided her first glimpse into the freedom America provides. Anusha read that brochure cover to cover. She joined the Girl Guides and learned that anything is possible. As Anusha shared with us, Girl Scouts empowers women from the earliest age when it's most important for them to have leadership opportunities. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to introduce you to Anusha Askuian, our January honoree, accompanied this evening by her Girl Scout partner, Claire Offenberger, a Girl Scout cadet in grade 8.
I am honored to stand alongside a woman I consider to be an important role model for today's girls. Congratulations, Ms. Askuian, on this very deserving honor. I joined the Girl Scouts in the first grade, the same year I was diagnosed with attention deficit disorder. Like Ms. Askuian, the Girl Scouts has helped me develop the courage and confidence to challenge obstacles that stand in my way. Girl Scouts has allowed me to acquire the leadership skills to achieve my goals. My participation in the Girl Scouts has inspired me to be my very best in everything I do. It has also given me the lifelong skills I will use to make the world a better place. Thank you, Ms. Askuian, for being a great inspiration to us all and for helping me realize the power of courage in achieving my dreams.
Our second nominee this evening is Dr. Judy Rosner. As a Brownie leader for her daughter's troop many years ago, Judy has been able to incorporate the learning from her Girl Scout experience into her vast career as an author and advocate of women. Judy believes strongly in the contributions of women and understands that companies with both men and women in their top ranks achieve the greatest success. She views the Girl Scouts as a safe environment where girls can develop the leadership skills to achieve personal and professional success. Please join me in recognizing our February honoree, the very accomplished Dr. Judy Rosner, who is accompanied by her Girl Scout partner, Chloe Smith.
Congratulations, Dr. Rosner. I am a Girl Scout Brownie in the second grade, and it is because of role models like Dr. Rosner that I am learning to be a leader. When it came time to sell cookies, I walked up and down the pier with cookies in my wagon and a smile on my face. I love to say the Girl Scout promise for my customers and to tell them about my Girl Scout badges. I think people like that because I sold the most Girl Scout cookies of any Girl Scout days in Orange County. Thank you, Dr. Rosner, for having me. Rosner for inspiring us all to be the very best we can be.
Our third honoree, Martha Daniel, grew up in Memphis, Tennessee, where she was a Girl Scout in one of the city's first African American troops. We all need a hero or two. For Martha, it was her Girl Scout troop leader, Ms. Miller. Growing up in a segregated community, Ms. Miller inspired the girls in Martha's troop to love themselves and always hold their heads up high. She taught them to make eye contact and speak loudly enough for people to understand them. She encouraged the girls to dream big because Ms. Miller was convinced that times were going to change. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating our March honoree, Martha Daniel, who is joined on stage by her Girl Scout partner, Sharon Gonzalez, a Girl Scout senior in grade 10.
Congratulations, Ms. Daniel, on being such an inspiration to all Girl Scouts, and especially to me. Just like Ms. Daniel, Girl Scouts has helped me develop the courage to be a leader when faced with prejudice. Once when I was selling cookies with my troop in front of a store, a woman who was interested in buying cookies walked away when she heard some of the girls speaking in Spanish. Some of the girls began to cry, and I explained to them why their talking in Spanish might have made the woman feel uncomfortable. By using the communication skills I learned in Girl Scouts, an unfortunate situation turned into a learning moment. Through Girl Scouts, I have developed a strong sense of who I am. I am proud of where I come from and excited about the journey ahead. Thank you, Ms. Daniel, for being a role model for us all.
It is now my pleasure to tell you about our fourth honoree, Julie Sokol. Growing up as a Girl Scout, Julie learned early on what it meant to be a part of a team, to appreciate the unique qualities each girl brings to their troop, and how their individual strengths can be harnessed to achieve greatness. Julie also developed courage and confidence through her participation in the wide array of activities the Girl Scouts provide. The Girl Scouts helped Julie face her fears at a young age as she pursued badges that took her out of her comfort zone. Overcoming her fears started Julie on a path of setting stretch goals for herself. She learned to be open to change and not afraid of failure. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming on stage our very accomplished April honoree, Julie Sokol, and her Girl Scout partner, Charlene Wang.
I am so excited and proud to be here this evening with Ms. Sokol and the rest of tonight's very accomplished honorees. Ms. Sokol's courage in welcoming change and the confidence she developed to act on it is something I can relate to. I am a Girl Scout senior in the 10th grade, and I too am embracing change in my quest to make the world a better place. For my Take Action project, I worked on a sustainable plan to improve the environment for future generations at Fount Valley's Mile Square Park. Through Girl Scouts, I have developed practical skills and the self-assurance to reach out and enlist the help of others for this ambitious project. Thank you, Ms. Sokol, for the inspiration you have provided us to embrace change and use it to enhance our lives.
Our fifth honoree, Sally Anderson, remembers being introduced to team building as a young girl attending Girl Scout camp, which she looked forward to all year long. She was a shy child, and camp helped Sally develop confidence. And there were plenty of other learning opportunities Sally was exposed to through the Girl Scouts. In building a campfire and setting up a tent, she learned about teamwork. She also learned that helping others learn skills she had already mastered is an important part of building team camaraderie. We're thrilled to honor you this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming on stage our honoree for May, Sally Anderson, and her Girl Scout partner, Jessica Sanchez.
Nice and
close.
Thank
you, Ms. Anderson, for being a great example for all of us.
Stand up. I am a Girl Scout Daisy. In the first grade, I enjoy helping others and collecting food for me and families. I also enjoy the many different activities we get to in Girl Scouts. I'm so excited to be here tonight. Thank you, Ms. Anderson, for showing us how to be the best we can be.
Awesome. It is now my pleasure to tell you about our sixth honoree, Kathy Bronstein. Kathy is a woman who really knows how to take a quality product and rev up its sales. So it came as no surprise that Kathy's success in business began when she sold her first box of Girl Scout cookies. Selling door to door, accompanied by her parents, Kathy developed confidence she had carried with her through her life. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce you to a woman who truly owns her success, our June honoree, Kathy Bronstein, accompanied by her Girl Scout partner, Gina Higazi.
I got it. Congratulations, Mrs. Bronstein. I'm honored to be here with you this evening. I'm a Girl Scout senior in the 10th grade, and like you, I have developed confidence through my Girl Scout experiences. Entering elementary school was a challenge for me. At first, I struggled to fit in, but the lessons and values I learned in Girl Scouts gave me the tools to resolve issues and communicate more effectively. I enjoy volunteering and feel great when I can brighten the day for others. My favorite volunteer opportunity is calling bingo at a homeless shelter. I buy prizes for the bingo players with money I earn collecting recyclables. Thank you, Mrs. Bronstein, for showing us what hard work and confidence can achieve. I am grateful for the lessons I have learned and will use them to make the world a better place.
It is now my privilege to tell you about our seventh honoree, the Honorable Loretta Sanchez. We are very pleased that she was able to make it back from Washington in time to be with us tonight. It takes a lot of confidence to break down barriers, and that's something Loretta has been doing her entire life. She became the first woman and first Latina to represent an Orange County congressional district. And as a young girl, she was the only Mexican-American at her school and the first Latina member of her Girl Scout troop. For most of her fellow troop members, this was their first experience with diversity. Please join me in congratulating our honoree for July, the Honorable Loretta Sanchez, who is being escorted by Olivia Bobrovnitsky, her Girl Scout partner, who's a Girl Scout junior in grade 4.
You inspire me, Congresswoman Sanchez. When you were a Girl Scout, you learned that it is important to speak up for what you believe, and now you are a Congresswoman. I am only in the 4th grade, but I too have developed enough confidence throughout my Girl Scout experiences to speak up when I see other children being treated unfairly. Sometimes it's hard, but I know in my heart that it's the right thing to do. Being a Girl Scout helps me feel connected to my community. My troop sisters and I perform flag ceremonies, and we help sick children and their families. We plant trees and collect food for needy people. We recycle things too. Like you, I have learned that I have the ability to make a difference in the world. Congratulations on your recognition tonight, and thank you for showing us what leadership is capable of achieving.
Our eighth honoree, Leanne Kennedy, is the owner and CEO of RE/MAX Fine Homes, the Kennedy Group. Given her success in real estate, I don't think anyone here will be too surprised when I tell you that as a little girl, Leanne was really good at selling Girl Scout cookies. The Girl Scout cookie program provided some of Leanne's earliest lessons in goal setting, and her confidence grew as she achieved her goals. Leanne likes the idea of girls developing business and entrepreneurial skills while earning money to help pay for their Girl Scout activities. And she shared that anything that can help a woman or girl understand her strengths and abilities to succeed is extremely important. Please join me in congratulating our August honoree, Leanne Kennedy, accompanied by our Girl Scout partner, Pauline Wallstrom, a Girl Scout ambassador in the 12th grade.
I was really honored to meet Ms. Candidate and to know that such an accomplished woman understands how important it is for girls to belong to Girl Scouts. I was diagnosed with autism in the third grade, and Girl Scouting has been my life. I have been in special education classes all through school, but thanks to the loving acceptance and support I've received, I have discovered that I have many strengths. I am very proud to have earned all three Girl Scout leaderships, the bronze, the silver, and the gold. Not many girls accomplish this. It was very gratifying to learn that Miss Candidate still uses the business skills she learned in Girl Scouts. Last year, I organized a campout for 240 girls, and I learned how to be organized, facilitate meetings, make budgets, and more. Girl Scouts taught me to be a leader, and I have these skills for life. Congratulations, Miss Candidate, on this recognition. You have inspired me.
It is a pleasure to tell you about our ninth honoree, Elizabeth Starr. Helping other people just seems to be ingrained in Elizabeth's character. Elizabeth credits the Girl Scout promise and law for providing her with excellent guidelines to live by. She also credits her mother, who was the troop leader when Elizabeth was in Girl Scouting, for being such a strong role model. Elizabeth has made it a priority in her own life to identify needs and look for solutions. When her own daughters were growing up, Elizabeth discovered there was no Girl Scout troop in their community for junior high girls. Knowing how vital Girl Scout leadership experiences are for girls at that vulnerable age group, Elizabeth started a troop for 120 girls in grades 6 through 8. She was so proud when several members of her troop, and I'm pretty sure some of them are here with us tonight, stayed in Girl Scouts throughout high school. Please join me in recognizing our honoree for September, Elizabeth Starr, and her Girl Scout partner, Patricia Kosolich, a Girl Scout ambassador in grade 11.
Congratulations, Mrs. Starr. You've done so much to make the world a better place. Knowing that you were once a Girl Scout and encouraged older girls to stay in Girl Scouting confirms what I already know. It's cool to be a Girl Scout, even when you're in high school. In Girl Scouting, I've learned, like you, that leaders look for solutions when there's a need. I've raised funds for orphans in Africa, and I'm currently working on a project to save California's dwindling marine kelp forests. I try, as you do, to live by the values in the Girl Scout promise and law. I even incorporate it into the cookie sale. I encourage customers to buy cookies and deliver them to military veterans. Last year, I delivered 700 boxes to the VA hospital in Long Beach and thanked each veteran personally. Thank you, Mrs. Starr, for being such a great example for today's young women.
Our 10th honoree, Arden Gardner, has experienced Girl Scouting from two vantage points, as a brownie when she was growing up, and as a mom who volunteered so her daughters could have the same character-building opportunities she had been given. Having seen how important it is for girls to learn practical skills like financial literacy, goal setting, and responsibility, Arden is concerned about the general lack of training in these important areas. She sees Girl Scouts as filling the gaps, especially for disadvantaged girls with limited opportunities. Please welcome our October honoree, Arden Gardner. She is accompanied by Maya Kovesic, a Girl Scout junior in grade 5.
I was so honored to meet a woman like Miss Gardner. She works so hard to help people whose lives are difficult, and that's the kind of person I want to be. Last year, I learned about a man who survived the Holocaust. He wrote a poem about tolerance, teaching people not to be bullies. I read the poem to my classroom so they could learn that bad things can happen if we don't stand up for ourselves and other people. That's one of the things I'm learning from Girl Scouts. That being a leader means recognizing when things are wrong or unfair, and that I have the power to take action.
I am pleased to share with you our 11th honoree, Cynthia Nishimoto. Cynthia has never approached anything half-heartedly. When she was a girl, she made it her goal to earn every Girl Scout badge, and she did it. In college, Cynthia became acutely aware of the many real-life skills Girl Scouts learn at an early age. She observed that many of the girls who hadn't been Girl Scouts didn't know how to plan, organize, speak their minds, or set goals. Cynthia was very grateful to have had those opportunities. Won't you please join me in honoring Cynthia Nishimoto, our honoree for November, and her Girl Scout partner, Sydney Anderson.
I'm a cadet in eighth grade, and I have learned being a leader means recognizing when something needs to be done and taking steps to make it happen, just like Miss Nishimoto. In fifth grade, I saw disabled children at my school being teased, and I protected them because that's what Girl Scouts learn to do. Then I started reading and playing games with them during lunch and recess. They were really happy, so before I moved to a new school, I recruited other students to visit them every day. Miss Nishimoto is an example of how Girl Scouts like me learn to stand up for what is right and grow up to be strong leaders who accomplish great things. Congratulations on your recognition tonight.
It is my privilege now to tell you about our 12th honoree, Nella Webster O'Grady. When Nella was growing up, her family moved a lot. Being a Girl Scout protected Nella from feeling like an outsider, especially when her family moved to Panama and then to Guam. Girl Scouts provided a place of belonging where Nella developed confidence in herself. Nella believes that this is one reason so many successful women were once Girl Scouts. The Girl Scout promise and law had a strong influence on Nella. The lessons and values she learned helped shape how she chose to live her life. Please join me in congratulating our December honoree, Nella Webster O'Grady, who is accompanied by Dipali Patel, a Girl Scout ambassador in grade 12.
Congratulations, Miss O'Grady. It really means a lot to know that your definition for success is a person who gives back to the community. The most important thing I've learned from Girl Scouts is to be a person who uses my abilities to help others. When I was younger, I was extremely timid and intimidated by other girls. Being a Girl Scout helped me break out of my shell. I learned to believe in myself and my abilities to be a better person. As a Girl Scout, I have had many community service opportunities, and I too have learned to be an advocate for people who didn't have a voice. Like you, the Girl Scout Promise and Law helped me establish my set of values. Thank you, Ms. O'Grady, for showing us that having a strong character can help us achieve success.
I hope you have been as inspired as I have by the many wonderful stories you have heard this evening. I was very moved by how many of the women, most recently Nella, and girls who referred to the Girl Scout Promise and Law as a guiding light in their lives. For those of you who were not Girl Scouts, the Promise and Law provide Girl Scouts with a set of values centered on honesty, fairness, personal responsibility, and mutual respect. It is the basis for the entire Girl Scout leadership program, and it is reflected in the way Girl Scouts treat one another and the world. Concern for others is paramount. And here in Orange County, Girl Scouts give more than 500,000 hours of community service each year. The Girl Scout Promise and Law is a code to live by that is shared by every Girl Scout. And now our girl representatives would like to share it with each of you.
God and my country, to help people at all times, and to live by the the Girl Scout law.
The Girl Scout law.
I will do my best to be honest and fair, friendly and helpful, considerate and caring, courageous and strong, and respectful for what I say and do, and respect myself and others, respect authority, use resources wisely, make the world a